shaken, not stirred.
He is Bond. James Bond. The crafty and charismatic secret agent who has been a thorn in the side of criminal masterminds for decades. And there's no signs of him stopping anytime soon as he continues to thwart the attempts for global domination of every mad scientist that comes his way. Over the years, we've seen many variations of the affluent and sometimes arrogant Agent 007, and many of Hollywood's leading men have had the privilege to play the iconic role. Folks, here is the entire James Bond timeline explained. It was in 1962 that moviegoers got their first look at Secret Agent 007 in the film Dr. No, an adaptation of Ian Fleming's James Bond novels, and history was made. Most James Bond adaptations, however, don't concentrate much on his early life, although a background story was established by creator Ian Fleming.
Shaken, not stirred.
In his first feature film, Dr. No, Bond travels to Jamaica to investigate the death of an MI6 station chief. After multiple attempts on his life, Bond ends up on the island of Crab Key, a fictional island off the coast of Jamaica. He then discovers the hideout of Dr. Julius No, a super intelligent scientist who had been recruited by the evil organization Spectre, the special executive for counterintelligence, terrorism, revenge, and extortion. Dr. No had planned to use his advancements in radiation to sabotage the Mercury space program, because that's what mad scientists do. In the end, Bond was able to thwart Dr. No's attempts to sabotage the space program, and as you may have guessed, the leaders of Spectre were not too happy about it. They vowed to get revenge on Bond, which led to a feud that lasted for years. We meet more of Spectre's leaders in From Russia with Love, including the enigmatic Number One. In any event, Bond was once again able to defeat Spectre, and their feud would carry on in future films. Next up, Goldfinger. In this film, Bond puts his feud with Spectre on hold to focus on a new enemy, Auric Goldfinger, a malevolent and maniacal man obsessed with wealth and great opulence. Goldfinger planned to detonate a bomb in Fort Knox and render the US supply of gold completely obsolete, which in turn would raise the value of his own supply of gold and put the world in economic turmoil. Bond manages to thwart Goldfinger's attempts at blowing up Fort Knox with the help of one of his former collaborators, the pilot Pussy Galore. In Goldfinger, we also get to see Bond's famous Aston Martin, equipped with an ejectable passenger seat. In the next Bond film, Thunderball, we see the return of Spectre and meet Emilio Largo, number two in the Spectre organization. Number two planned on hijacking two nuclear bombs from NATO to hold the world hostage, but Bond managed to put number two to rest with the help of Largo's former mistress, Domino. Bond goes on to battle Spectre once again in You Only Live Twice, and we are introduced to the mysterious leader of Spectre, Ernest Stravo Blofeld. This time around, Bond goes undercover and infiltrates Spectre's volcano lair and puts an end to their plan of starting World War III. Bond gets married. Bond had earned quite a reputation for swooning women and effectively sweeping them off their feet. One might wonder how a secret agent finds time for love while pursuing some of the world's most dangerous criminals. On Her Majesty's Secret Service had Bond tracking Blofeld once again, while engaging in a romance with Tracy DiVincenzo, the daughter of a crime syndicate leader who agreed to give Bond information on Blofeld. Blofeld had brainwashed 12 women to be his angels of death and used them as biological weapons to compromise the world's food supply. Bond managed to defeat Spectre once again with the help of Tracy's father and his allies, and married Tracy. Their union was cut tragically short, however, when Blofeld and his operative Irma do a drive-by on Bond's car and took Tracy's life, a tragedy that would end up haunting Bond for years. Diamonds Are Forever. Diamonds Are Forever features Bond doing battle with Blofeld once again and would be the last film in the EON Bond series that would feature Sean Connery in the role of the iconic secret agent 007. This time, Blofeld was involved in a diamond smuggling ring and the construction of a diamond-encrusted laser, but Bond was once again able to put an end to Blofeld's plans. Live and Let Die was the beginning of the Roger Moore era of James Bond and did not feature any major Spectre storylines. In this standalone film, Bond travels to the Caribbean to investigate the deaths of three MI6 agents. After some investigation, he uncovered a plot by the island's leader, Dr. Kanaga, to distribute illicit substances in a chain of restaurants. Bond is able to defeat the doctor with the help of Kanaga's advisor, Miss Solitaire, the man with the golden gun. In this film, Bond discovered that Francisco Scaramanga had stolen a device that could disrupt the world's energy production and disrupt the world's economy to boot. Bond and Scaramanga face off on a remote island near China, and Bond is able to ultimately defeat his foe. Next up, it was The Spy Who Loved Me that had Bond investigating a series of missing submarines. He teamed up with Soviet spy Anya Amasova and located the secret underwater lair of scientist Carl Stomberg and stopped him from launching nuclear missiles at New York and Moscow. We also got to meet one of Bond's most memorable foes, the metal-toothed maniac known as Jaws. Over the course of the next four Bond films, 007 traveled the world and defeated mad scientists and other criminals, including a power-hungry Russian general. Next, Bond teamed up with CIA agent Holly Goodhead to stop Hugo Drax from releasing a nerve gas from his secret space station. Bond inevitably thwarted Drax's attempts at creating a quote-unquote perfect civilization. In For Your Eyes Only, Bond teamed up with his vengeful young female companion to stop a top-secret British computer from falling into Soviet hands. But before he went about his new mission, he met an old foe, Blofeld, in the cold open scene for the movie, and put an end to him once and for all. In Octopussy, Bond went up against Soviet generals once again and stopped a nuclear Bond plot. In A View to Kill, Bond went to San Francisco and stopped Max Zorin from unleashing his wrath on Silicon Valley. New era. Timothy Dalton was next in line to play the iconic James Bond. In The Living Daylights, Bond is once again involved in Cold War schemes and uncovered a web of deceptions and lies. Next, Bond teamed up once again with his old CIA pal, Felix Leiter, in A License to Kill. Bond took on and destroyed a South American drug cartel in the process. The Pierce Brosnan era of James Bond began with the movie Goldeneye. This time around, Bond dealt with the fallout from the Cold War and went up against his former partner 006, who had faked his demise in order to lead a criminal organization. Like always, Bond managed to come out on top and prevented the fall of Britain's economy. In Tomorrow Never Dies, Bond faced off against media mogul Elliot Carver, who had planned to deceive the world by promoting a phony war between Britain and China. In The World Is Not Enough, Bond went up against his former friend and ex-KGB agent who planned on stealing Russian plutonium in order to create a devastating bomb. Then in Bronson's final film, Die Another Day, Bond goes toe-to-toe with a Korean colonel who had planned to spark a war between North and South Korea. Of course, Bond saved the day in the end. Another new timeline. The Bond timeline got a complete makeover in Casino Royale, which saw the beginning of the Daniel Craig era of Bond. Throughout most of the movie, Bond is investigating the funding of criminal organizations through a dangerous banker known as Lechiffre, with the help of British Treasury agent Vesper Lynn. Lechiffre is ultimately done away with by a man known as Mr. White, and Bond then discovers that Vesper Lynn might be a double agent. When Bond tries to confront Vesper, he is stopped by Mr. White's men. Vesper ended up sacrificing herself, and it was revealed that her supposed betrayal was actually part of a deal she made with White in order to save Bond's life. Bond was haunted by this and vowed to get vengeance by tracking down White. New enemies. Quantum of Solace is the next movie in the Bond timeline. Bond captures and interrogates Mr. White and discovers the criminal organization known as Quantum, who were set on controlling Bolivia's water supply to create a monopoly. But Bond triumphs in the end and is finally able to let go of his feelings of grief over the passing of his former ally Vesper Lynd. Skyfall was the next movie in the Bond timeline and saw Bond and his superior M do battle with ex-MI6 agent Raoul Silva. In the end, Bond was able to defeat Silva, but M lost her life, and Bond was once again forced to mourn the loss of an important woman in his life. In the movie Spectre, we saw Bond following a lead left for him by his fallen comrade, M. Bond teamed up with Mr. White's daughter, Madeleine Swan, and discovered that all of his former enemies, including Lechiffre, members of Quantum, and Raoul Silva, can be traced back to the criminal organization Spectre, and a man by the name of Franz Oberhauser. It was then revealed that Oberhauser's real name was actually Blofeld, and that he knew Bond as a child. Blofeld revealed that he was the one who took the life of Bond's father. In the end, Bond is able to defeat Blofeld, who remains alive, however, leaving room for future sequels. Well, folks, that is the entire history of the James Bond timeline. Is there something new that you learned from watching this video? And what do you think the future holds for Agent 007? Let us know down in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to Screen Rant. Thanks for watching, and stay safe out there.